Now, if we want to get every other character in a string or some interval of characters, we can use the step size in string slicing. So what happens when we have a string and we try to slice it with no values included? Well, we get the entire string returned. With that, default start being the first character or index 0, and the default end going past the last character so that we return the entire string. In this example, we're going to add a third element, and that's called the step. So we have our start value, our stop value, and then this 2 is a step. And that tells you how many we will skip at the interval. And we're counting from the start value to the stop value. So let's go ahead and look at what the step of 2 is with the default to 0 to end of the string. And we see that at the 0 index, and then we go to the 2 index, the 4 index, and the 6 index, because we step by 2. In this example, we start with the second character, which is at index. We start 0, 1, and then we're going to take a step of 2. So let's look at that one. We started at index 1, and then we went to 3 and 5, and then we are ended, and so we just get OET return. And this final one with long word variable using consequences, we're going to start at index 1, which is the second character, and then go through index 9, or the 9th character rather, and stopping at index 9. So 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, and then we'll stop at 9. And then we're going to get every other character, and let's run that one. And we get letter O at index 1, and then S, and then Q, and then E, and then we stop. So we can still use the start and end values. Okay, we can easily reverse a string by using a step size of negative 1, which is minus 1. So in our first example here, using a negative step value, we're going to look at long word variable, a variable that has 15 letter string characteristics, and we use the negative step. So let's look at the start value and the end value and see what this look like. The default here, it seems to start with the last character and end with first character. Let's look at our second example here, where we start at the 6th index, which is letter T, and taking a negative step again. And we see that it starts at the T and went back to the print the first character. And so it just stops before that first one. Okay, if we want to easily reverse a string, or we want to iterate backwards through each character in a string, we can use this negative one step value.